One of the key messages from the panel discussion we had yesterday around supply chain resilience for me is the fact that thanks to digital and data management and new technology, we will be able in a very near future to totally change the flexibility and the agility of our supply chains. It will give us the opportunity to reduce even further our lead time thanks to autonomous manufacturing supply point, and as well with in view the visibility of our end-to-end supply chain, we will be able to have access to real-time data, so we will be able to evaluate and understand the impact of any change in demand, for instance, very quickly, and so we will be able to act as well very quickly. So I think it would be a way to totally change the way we take decisions based on real-time data, and then that will be a game changer in terms of agility and flexibility. Our mission is to supply life-changing medicine to patients which are on a really, really high need of it. So flexibility and agility is key because time is the essence. So, and for me, it's at all levels. So if you think about new market, being more agile and more flexible means reducing the time it takes to put on market new product, which can really change totally life of patient. And then for established product, the more flexible and agile we are, the more we can ensure whatever happens, any event, our patient, no patient will be left without medicine. So we are seeing a change in terms of volume of product we manufacture, mainly due to the change in the portfolio. And one of the challenges it can create is when the same supply manufacturing site has to produce both large volume and small volume as part of the transition or the transformation. So what is really important is the segmentation. I don't think as soon as you can avoid to use the same equipment for large volume and small volume, start to dedicate specific equipment for low volumes, use modular assets which are much more flexible. That makes a big difference. And then the other thing which is key is operational excellence and ensure we continuously improve our efficiency to manufacture small volume in a cost-effective manner. I think when you think about business continuity and risk management, what is really important is not to focus only on one part, but really look at your whole supply chain. So starting with material sourcing, you need to decide where do you want to dual source. You can't dual source everywhere, but with a strategic approach, where do you want to dual source? And you balance between dual sourcing and appropriate inventory management. If you think about your packaging or component, for instance, simplification, standardization is key because it helps as well manage the risk better. And you need to think about the whole chain up to the distribution. So distribution is really key because if you manufacture your medicine but you can't bring it to the patient, and we've seen a lot of events which can disturb distribution when you think geopolitical issue as well as some of the climate change impact we see. So qualifying alternative distribution route, for instance, is a good example of how you can mitigate risk in that space. So I think really important to look at the end-to-end supply chain. really like the fact that we have a good mix between presentation, high quality presentation, but as well the opportunity to meet with partners and understand a bit better what they can, which kind of support they can bring us. I think that's one of the quality of the summit. It has been great, and as well a great opportunity to network, meet new people, and it's a great opportunity to learn from each other. So that's as well one of the great benefits of this summit.